Hey you guys, it's Peter, and welcome to my channel, Peterisms, where I tell stories of my life and just little things that I have learned as I have grown into the person that I am today. And, oh, Tucker was going to help me, but he decided he was not going to help me. I guess. Oh, he's, now Boo Radley is up here, and he decided that he was going to help me. You going to come up here, Tucker? Come on. They all want to be up here. Okay, well, I have, I actually was not going to make this video tonight. I was just like sitting outside on the front porch. It's like 70 degrees outside or 60, some in the 60s. It's so nice outside. And I was just like listening to my neighbors, and I put new sheets on the bed and opened the windows, and I put in these new candles in the kitchen, and everything is like so nice and, I cannot speak tonight. Everything is so nice and homey. I was like, do I want to make another video? Do I not want to make another video? And I was like, you know what? I think I could use some meditations today. So let's get into this. Let's see. I don't know. Let me clean off my glasses really quickly. I don't know which one I want to read. Oh, you know what? I actually read from the Daily Book of Positive Quotations earlier, and I really liked the meditation. So let's start with that one. I got up super early this morning, and I tried to go to breakfast with my good Jitty Tanya Jean, but she wasn't up yet. So my friend Sarah, Alex's best friend, and I, we went out to breakfast/brunch. We had a great brunch. We had avocado toast and lemon ricotta pancakes, and I had orange juice and coffee, and we had such a great breakfast lunch. And then before that, I had gone to Target, and I've had a full day, and I came home and I took a nap with the dogs for like 2 hours. It was fantastic. I've had a really nice day today. So let's get into the meditation. This is from the Daily Book of Positive Quotations. I loved this meditation today about change. November 4th, let's get in here. November 4th, willing change. It is not by spectacular achievements that man can be transformed, but by will. Henrik Ibsen. How do we change ourselves? How do we change the world? We hope for saviors, for magic, for something wonderful that will bring peace and understanding, that will end hunger, that will give children everywhere the chance to grow up safe. While we hope for saviors and magic, we also must set our will and do what we can on our own to make a difference. I'm not sure what I can do to change the world and help make it better, but I'll find something. If each of us does one small thing, the world will change. I love this meditation so much, you know? And I think it's rather apropos, being that it's, you know, election day today in the United States. Or not that it's election day, it's like we're waiting for the election results today. And, you know, I was thinking about this meditation earlier, and it's interesting because I think we live in a world, you know, where we look to others to make change without, I think, often asking ourselves what we can do. And, you know, I remember going to my Aunt Kathy's funeral, and my Aunt Kathy was somebody that did a lot, but I didn't know what she did, you know, necessarily. And one of her really close friends that had been her neighbor at one point, I shared this story on here before, got up and gave a eulogy. And I gave a eulogy at my aunt's funeral too, but during this eulogy, she shared all of these things that my aunt had done, like all of these charity activities that she had done. And my aunt, like one of the things that she was really involved in was like taking food to people's homes, like homeless people, or not homeless people, but people that were lower income. And she had done that for like a long time. And I didn't know that, like she would make these meals and then she would take them to their houses and things like that. And I didn't know that she had done that. And there were all of these things that she'd done, all these fantastic things, you know? I knew that she had been on charity boards. I knew that she had, you know, done all that. But, like, there were a lot of, like, hands-on things that I was not aware of that she had done. And, you know, that is the act of altruism, is, you know, doing good deeds and not telling anyone. And sadly, I think that we live in a world where we do nice things for people and then we want a pat on the back. I'm not going to say that I haven't been that person too, because I have. You know, like when you pay for somebody's coffee at Starbucks, you're kind of like, you look in the rearview mirror, like, did they see me? Did they see me? You know, like, did they see that I bought their coffee for them? That's why every night of my vlog, I say, well, when I do the long outro, I say, you know, and also practice random acts of kindness. But also, like I always say, don't tell anyone. Just do it to put compassion, love, kindness out there in the world. And if you really, really think about this on a daily basis, all of the opportunities that we have to do good deeds, whether it's giving somebody a parking space or opening a door for somebody, just really nice small things, right? Or just improving somebody's day, just saying, hey, I hope you have a better day. Or being an ear to somebody that needs to, you know, hear something, you know, that needs to talk or whatever. You know, there are so many things that we can do, to donating money, to donating time, to donating, you know, goods of things that we have, you know, around the house, whether that be blankets or shoes or canned food and things. I mean, there's so many things in this world that we can do, right? And you can pick whatever it is that you want to focus on. And my husband and I were having this conversation a couple weeks ago, and he said something about, we were talking about like political activism, and I said, you know, when I was younger, I was like very, very involved. And he was like, you were? And I was like, I mean, he didn't know me when I was like, you know, 18 to 25. And I said, oh yeah. I said, I was extremely involved in, you know, like LGBTQIA plus organizations. And you know, I went to all the Earth Day festivals, and I did, you know, candlelight vigils and things like that. I was really, really involved, and I was involved in like 10 different efforts, if that makes sense. And one of the things that I realized for me personally, this is just for me, was that if I was doing a little bit on all of these things, I wasn't really making any kind of grand effect or change. And so I decided for me that I had to pick one area that was really important to me and put all my time and effort into that area. And that area for me that I chose was addiction and recovery. Because that is something that I'm, if you watch my videos, you know, I'm like absolutely passionate about, you know? And that's something for me that like, I feel like every day I fight the good fight. If that makes sense. It's something that I really, really believe in, you know, and for me, it comes in the way of educating people about addiction. It comes in the way of humanizing addiction, you know, and letting people know that addicts and alcoholics are not bad people trying to get good. They're sick people trying to get well. And I try to educate people on the process of hope, because I try to be an example for people out there that you can get sober. I try to share the story of my mother and I to let people know that there are families that are in recovery together, and that you can maybe have hope for somebody. My mom was 51 when she got sober, you know? So don't ever give up hope on a parent. You know, I have friends of mine that are 60 and 70 that have recently gotten sober. And, you know, I try to talk about the opioid crisis that's in our country right now. But, you know, every day that I get up, I think to myself, you know, today is an opportunity for change. You know, it's like the Gandhi saying, like, you know, I'll mess it up. I know I will. I'm horrible with quotes, you guys. But what is it? Be the change you want to see in the world. And I'm such a, that's a Gandhi quote, right? Please. I hope so. Somebody will say no. It's like so and so. But I am such a believer in that, you know, and like, it's funny because, you know, I like beauty pageants. You hear that quote a lot in beauty pageants, right? About be the change you want to see in the world. But I really think it's true, you know? I really do. It's like, for so long, there was like kind of a like a nervousness, of anxiety about me. I think we look at like being like manic as like kind of a clinical term, so I don't want to use that, but almost kind of like that with me, you know? And I would see people that were like so calm and so peaceful, and they were really, because they were done so much work on themselves, they were just presenting to the world as very calm and peaceful. And they were able to be calm and peaceful other people when they needed them. They were able to suit up and show up. And that has really been one of the things I've attempted in the last couple years, you know, is that I need to suit up and show up and be able to be present for people when they need me. And I was just talking to Tanya, my best friend Tanya, about this the other night. Like, in the last 10 years, and especially like the last 2 or 3 years, like, I've worked so hard on all of that just kind of like the anger and the resentment and all of that. I don't really have any of that anymore. And that allows me to be, you know, a vehicle of peace and serenity to those around me. And see, I have to take care of myself, because when I am not, this is where it comes in and talks about be the change you want to see in the world. You know, when you are kind of like frazzled and out of sorts and constantly like, ah, blah, 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 for me at least, for me, when I'm like that, like, I'm no good for anybody else. I'm not helping anybody. I'm not an ear for anybody else. I'm not being a teachable moment for anybody else. And I'm not proud of those moments that I've, you know, been that. I don't want to be that today. So for me, it starts with taking care of myself. It starts with, well, how can I be a good role model to my husband or to my friends or to my nephews or to my family or to anybody that watches my videos? If I'm like, you know, and wired and full of anger and resentment, I can't be. I can't be, right? And there's such a horrible emotional roller coaster that goes through with that, that every day that I'm feeling that and I'm stepping in that is just like trudging through, you know, quicksand, if that makes sense. And so, is that my phone? I feel like I can hear, I always have my phone on silent, but I can hear it like buzz when somebody calls. So that means that I have to take care of myself. That change that I want to see in the world, what I want to see in the world is peace and serenity. What I want to see in the world is people getting along, people caring about each other, people being compassionate towards each other. You know, we say that same, but do we really ask what we want from that? I don't want people to suffer anymore. I want people to have hope. I want people to be kind to one another. And if I want that in the world and it starts with me, then I have to ask myself, am I being kind today? Am I being compassionate towards other people? Am I being an ear for other people that need to maybe just vent and get some things out? Am I helping people when the opportunity arises? Am I seeking out opportunities where I can be a better human being today? And am I, you know, using those things in my life? Because we all like, okay, my issue is addiction and recovery, but we all have something. We all have something in our life, okay? You know, it's also for me been being gay and, you know, showing my husband and I in videos together and talking about marriage counseling. Like, that's something that's very important to me as well, you know? We all have some story to tell that we can be, a system of support for other people, that we can be that change. We can say, hey, I've gone through this, or you're going to make it through this, you know, or this is, you know, whatever it is for you, whether that is, a sickness or an illness in your life that you've gone through, or just tough times, or whatever it is, you know, that you've lived through about turning your wounds into wisdom. That might be your opportunity to help others, to share that with others, you know? Like, I always tell people, like, when they're going through something really hard, they're like, I don't really know why this is existing in my life today. I'm like, well, it might be existing so that down the road, you're present to help somebody else. Like, your story of what you're going through right now may be there and may exist for you to be able to help somebody else, so that when somebody else is in a situation and you go, wow, that looks familiar because I've been there, then you can say, hey, can I help you? Can I let you know what works for me and what got me through that? And then that person takes it on and shares it with somebody else. I say this all the time. Nothing that I share on this these videos on this channel are anything unique. This is not wisdom that I came up with myself. These are things that people handed to me, you know? And I talk all the time about calling people that you like, reach out to somebody and let them know how much they mean to you. Today, one of my sponsors from the past reached out to me and left a really funny, nice message. And, you know, it was like, as soon as I heard it, my immediate response was, I need to start calling more people. I try to every day at least call or contact one person in my life that I haven't talked to in a while and let them know how much they mean to me. But like, I was like, I need to do that more often. Like, that human connection is so powerful. And I think sometimes we're like afraid to just pick up the phone and text somebody and just be like, you know, like when we were like all stuck at home inside and couldn't go anywhere, like a lot of people did that, I felt like, you know, but just to reach out to somebody and say, hey, I was thinking of you today, blah, 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 you know what I mean? And so I want to say a special thank you to my special friend that goes to my home group meetings. She knows, she watches these videos. She told me she watches these videos every single day. And, you know, she is somebody that I don't think she really even knew that at the time that I came back from going to meetings, or hadn't gone to meetings for 4 years, there were a group of about, like, I don't know, 5 or 10 people that I made as very close friends that every day that I would walk into these meetings, these noon meetings, that I would see them and they would, you know, hey, Peter, how are you? And, you know, we would stand outside afterwards and talk. She was a friendly face that just happened to be present when I needed a friendly face in my life, okay? And we think that maybe that's not a lot. But had I not had friendly faces at that time, I don't know that I would have come back. I don't know that I would be sitting here right now. I don't know that eventually I wouldn't have picked up. I'm so thankful for you, dear. You know that. I love you. And, you know, I'm so thankful that people made me feel welcome and that people made me feel comfortable, you know, to come back. And even just that, just smiling at somebody or to say, hey, how are you today? You know, just those small things are ways that we can be of service to other people, that we can be that change that we want to see in the world, you know? I want a happy, kinder, more compassionate world. That's why I try to surround myself with people that are happier, or at least honest if they're not happy, you know, about what they're going through. Kinder, more compassionate world. And if I want that, then I have to be that. So anyway, that was a great meditation. I love that when I read that earlier today. Let me know what you think about that in the comment section below. I love you guys, and I will see you tomorrow.